We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Radiant Black Issue 2. This is a 2021 series from Image Comics, written by Kyle Higgins, art by Marcelo Costa, letters by Becca, Carey, edited by Michael Bustilli. I have cover A by Marcelo Costa. Kind of a boring cover, doesn't tell me anything about it. If I wasn't already going to pick this book up, I wouldn't pick it up on that cover. That tells me nothing about it, doesn't even really show me the hero. It looks more like some guy clicking his fingers. I could care less about some dude in a motorcycle helmet. All right, so we start off the book with Nathan sitting down and having oatmeal with his dad. And that goes on way too long. And then we see that his friend is tracked down by the cops, and the cops show up at Nathan's house. And it's the two officers from issue one, and they are trying to uncover whether or not Nathan has any connection to a similar person wearing a red suit. Well, they kind of put him on the track of finding out what's going on, and it's not necessarily for their benefit per se, but the guy's doing a crime wave and they kind of want to know if Blue here is connected to it. Well, he tracks the guy down pretty easily and starts a fight with him inadvertently by being an idiot. And I don't want to give too much away, but Nathan's a moron. Then we wrap up the issue with him having oatmeal with his dad again. There's about 6 or 7 pages of him talking to his dad having oatmeal that were so massively boring and stupid and pointless. If you pick this up in the trade paperback, it won't be as annoying. But when you're paying $4 for 7 pages of two people eating oatmeal talking about you have to get a job because you're a deadbeat, oh my god, what a waste of time and money. This could have been a 2-page conversation at most and done much more succinctly. They padded this thing so bad with that. Then there's a couple of panels later on that could have been cut out. There's a lot of dialogue that could have been trimmed down that just is blather. The way that Nathan finds the other person is useful, so I didn't have a problem with that. I thought that was fairly creative. But Nathan's a moron. He drove his own car to find this guy, so this guy would easily be able to find him. And that was just dumb. Nathan's not very smart. He's not particularly heroic. He has to get kind of pushed into helping. I'm having a hard time caring. He at least does the right thing in the end, but man, this was just padding after padding after padding, which is really sad. It was so decompressed and drawn out that it really seemed like they didn't know where they were going with this, and we had to have 6 pages of him talking to his dad about oatmeal and getting a job. It was really not worth $4. The art's okay. I didn't have a problem with that. It's got a particular style, like Firepower and other books like that. The costumes look cool, but this guy Nathan is really annoying, and he's kind of dumb. I don't really care about him, and his dad's annoying, and the whole thing where they're sitting around eating for a third the book was a complete waste of my time. I'm gonna quit here. This might be better in trade paperback, but I'm not buying individual issues for two people eating stuff to make themselves regular. What a waste of time and a waste of my $4. Beyond that, if you pick this up out of a discount bin, it'd probably be worth it, but I'm checking out here because I am not going to spend $4 a month on pointless drivel and people trying to make themselves poop later. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel out in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.